I guess some of it would be to keep going and to keep trying. And there is great change being made. And I guess some of the wonderings is, well, what do we do now? Like, as far as, you know, your support that was provided provincially, and kind of where do we go to now? But I think, you know, when I hear that and I say, well, people need to know it's in you, like you have what it takes to keep going. And so I think that's important to know and for people to believe and understand. Well, the project of heart, but I think when you're sharing, like, and even throughout today is that, and yesterday was, we're doing a lot of like the same things, like we're headed in the same direction. And so sometimes we think, like we need to reach outside of our district or our school walls to reach out to other people. And so like with the Project of Heart ebook, you know, that's been exciting because working with, you know, you've been helping to connect with other districts for the work, and it's, you know, collaborating with other schools across the province and to come together collectively to create something for use for all. And we talk about, like, where is this work going to go? And we talk about, well, ideally, and it is to support our kids and our students within the schools, but we think it's useful for, you know, educators, community members, within our own school communities, but provincially, and then, you know, Canada-wide. And I imagine others outside Canada will look to this resource to help them understand, you know, residential school education from a First Nation, Métis, and Inuit perspective from Alberta. We're all working on a lot of the same things. And so, you know, we talk about, well, we don't need to reinvent the wheel because that is wasting our time, and that we could work together to collaborate and share and then move forward. And so anyone is more than welcome to access our resources and on our website. And we encourage people to make them their own, because what works for Edmonton Public Schools doesn't necessarily work for all, but it's a good starting point. And so we work hard on trying to role model, you know, the idea of generosity for others. And I know for some people, they are shy to share their resources because they feel that others may judge them or, you know, evaluate their resources. But I think we need to move past that and to think about, we're doing it for our kids and, you know, working hard to help support First Nation, Métis, and Inuit students and eliminating that achievement gap and supporting First Nation, Métis, Inuit education and culture and building capacity within our school systems to support our kids. Our First Nation, Métis, and education team, we just want to be like massive district-wide. Everyone is going to do this, and it's mandated that everyone has to implement this resource or make this change. But we know that to make effective, sustainable change, we need to completely know and understand the reason why we're doing what we do. And we need to personally believe in what we're doing. And so I think the change, it takes time. And you know, talk about celebrating the small successes within schools, within system leaders, you know, we were thrilled when our superintendent and our board of trustees were willing and wanted to go through the blanket exercise, and that has just been amazing. And I find you know, when we talk about our circle of influence and, you know, when you impact that one person, we know that they will impact others and it will just continue to grow and grow. And so to have faith in the process and to trust the process, because I see it happening and it's just been absolutely amazing. You know, when we talk about reconciliation and knowing that our superintendent is, you know, completely 100% on board and believe strongly in that. And when you have someone like our superintendent that can role model that for others, is very effective. And it has been amazing. And I'm quite proud of the work that our district is doing. So it makes me happy. Well, we talk about relationships, right? And building relationships with people to trust that you're going to take them in the right place. Because, you know, I know you and we talk about, I don't know what I don't know, right? And it's, well, you need to build that relationship with them so they trust that what you're going to share and where you're going to take them is a place that's authentic and meaningful. And they continue to grow off of that. I would like to share it with all of our lead teachers and our upcoming lead teacher sessions. And so I would like for teachers to experience it, because I know with the blanket exercise, we did that with our lead teachers, and it has been phenomenal, the amount of people that have requested it, either in their classrooms or for their staff meetings. So I feel that will happen with the brain game. I feel it's another avenue for people to reflect on their own understanding of historical and contemporary realities for our First Nation, Métis, and Inuit students, families, and community members. So I know that for some people, it's you share with them something, but sometimes it's not that what they want to hear at that moment. And so using different tools to help inspire people to want to keep moving forward. So I feel the brain game is another one of those great learning tools that we can share with our district. You know, I was excited about this day, but I guess reflecting now, I just feel like, you know, it's been great having you as a resource, as a go-to person, and you have shared so much within the time that you have been with Edmonton, like supporting our district. So I guess I just want to thank you. Thank you so much. I look forward. I know that when people are involved in this work, it isn't because they have to do something, it's because they want to do something. And so I thank you, because I know that your heart is in the right place.